In this lecture, I will place text on a three-dimensional object. Let's create a 3D cube in Inkscape. I've already created a cube before, and we'll show the basics. I select the 3D box tool. I click and drag from the left corner. I've now drawn a small part of the cube. To make it fit, I drag a front corner to the same place. I can increase the length by dragging one of the four nodes. To go the other way, I hold shift and drag the opposite corner. And to make the cube higher, I hold control and drag a corner. I can also prolong from the bottom, holding control. And I can prolong from the front or from the back, holding the control key. I go to outline preview mode by pressing control Y. If I zoom out, I see I place the vanishing points of the three converging lines at the same distance, using a circle. The vanishing points also have equal distance to each other. This way, you get a uniform cube. If I bring a vanishing point closer to the cube, I will create more perspective. In the menu above, you can also change finite converging lines to infinite parallel lines by clicking on the toggle icons. I prefer, however, to work with three vanishing points for realistic results. And by dragging the little cross, I can move the cube in 3D space. I will finalize the cube by going to Path, Object to Path. In my layers, I see the cube exists of six planes. If I hold Alt, I can see which plane corresponds with a path. I only need the front planes, so I delete the back planes. I call the object Cube. I will flip the cube horizontally. Now let's place the text. To easily place the text on the cube planes, I will first place the text on a square. With the rectangle tool, I create a square by holding control. I will duplicate it twice. I select the text tool. For my font, I will use Alpha Slab 1, which is a free Google font. I click and type outside. I hold down Alt and decrease the line height with the arrow up key. I will make the text fit the square and leave the edge visible. I will also place text on the other squares. To easily place the text on the cube, I will cut the text from the squares. So I select the text in a square and go to Path, Difference. I will give the paths a name. I make the background a bit lighter. And I make the cube black. To place the text in perspective, I go to Path Effects. From the menu, I choose Perspective Envelope. Behind Type, I choose Perspective. I select the Node tool and activate snapping. When I drag the corner nodes, they will snap to the corners of the cube. I make Think 80% gray. Next, I place outside. In Path Effects, I choose Perspective Envelope. With the Node tool, I place the text. Finally, I place the box. I make the box 10% gray.